happening. No gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what's up guys, Craft Farms here, and welcome back to another video on County Line. Oops. So we're here at Crop Production Services with the Duramax and one of the anhydrous tanks. Had to run up here and refill, so now we gotta run this one back to the farm and grab the other one and bring that one up here and refill it, and then we can get back to putting down some anhydrous. So we're gonna head back to the farm here, grab the other one, and run back. Now we got a good portion of the field done so far. There's still quite a bit to do, but hopefully it shouldn't take too long, though. Kind of a long trek when you're driving slower. It's really not that far away though. I don't know why I didn't just go in that way. That's actually what I'm gonna do. Turn around here and go in this way. Shut those off for now. Driving the grass alongside the field here. So you can see we still have this big section left, but the section that I was doing in the last video on this map, I'm just about done with that. There's like four or five passes left, and that section's done. And then, so hopefully we'll finish that section off, and then, we'll be able to do that little section over there, and or at least majority of it in this video, and then I can do a bunch of this section off camera, and then we can finish it on Sunday, or Friday, I mean, not Sunday. Right up here, drop that one. And then we'll head back. Okay, and here we are. About time. So we're gonna let that sit there, and we're gonna run back to this, and we're gonna start back to work, because we're not gonna need that tank for a while anyways. So won't need it for a little while, because these tanks last a fair amount of time. So you can see we got 4 passes left till we're done with this section that I cut out. So hope you guys like the little cut scene that I did there. I just kind of got to thinking about that as I was driving and decided to try it out. See, I did shut this off. Right. Turn off. It's not putting anything down anyways. Here comes this fun turn. Miss a little section, but whatever. Well, maybe not. I think I got it, actually. It's knocking this field out bit by bit. Definitely wish that the 5-fold applicator was done and released already. But it's still being worked on. If you guys want to see the progress on that, go check out BrainDead4554 on Facebook. Pretty sure it's 4554. It's something like that. He's the guy that made the tank and the applicator and whatnot. So he's the one that's making the 5-fold as well. So you can go check out his progress on that, as well as some other stuff that he's working on. I know he's got a John Deere, I think it's 7520 or something like that. Some kind of an older John Deere that he's working on. He does a lot of cool work. Doing this with like a sprayer would definitely be a lot faster, but I don't do anhydrous a whole lot, and kind of neat to do it once in a while here, so might as well do it, huh? And yes, I am going into the grass, but whatever. Whoa! Turned a lot sharp on that. I do definitely like how he's got this set up so that you can see the anhydrous coming out. Oh, shoot. I didn't realize that does that. Okay. How you can see the anhydrous coming out of the applicator when you have it raised and turned on. I didn't realize I didn't fertilize when you do that, so oh well. It's no big deal, I guess. So I got all kinds of stuff ready to rock and roll for this week. I got, you know, recording this right now, it's Sunday. It's coming up to 1:30, and I got getting this video done, and then can get this one rendering and whatnot out of Shotcut, and then while that does that, I can get the FS13 video recorded, that or the next video of this. whichever one I decide to do. But then I got my notepad here. It's got all the stuff that I need every week, and pencil, so that way I could write it in and then just erase it every week. I'll have to make a new one each week like I have been, because I draw it out in pen and then I just write all the check marks in pen, and so then I just gotta start all over. But so basically it has, you know, what day. So like Monday, FS15, Tuesday, FS13, Wednesday, map, Wednesday, car, meaning my summer car, Thursday, modding, Friday, FS15, Saturday, FS13, Sunday, car, Sunday, map, and then what time those will be uploaded. And then I have a checklist of, is it recorded? Okay, so I check the recorded box. Is it edited? Yes. Okay, check the edited box. Uploaded? Yep, check that box. And then, have I applied the cards to it yet? No. Yes, whatever. You know, if so, check the box, that kind of stuff. So just kind of a thing to keep me in, I don't know, keep me in line, I'll say. You know, just to ensure that I get everything done that I need to get done. So, got one more pass, and then we're working on that small section there. That shouldn't take too long to do, hopefully. There's definitely going to be a lot of anhydrous videos for a while. Because, I mean, we got this field. And then we've got how many others? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We got 7 other fields to do. We only own 8 fields at the moment. Hopefully in the future we can expand to field 19 and 21 and farther. But for now, these fields, they do the job. Eventually hope to upgrade to that area as well. That's got 2 sheds and a big grain complex on it that you can buy. There's 2 other grain complexes spread out around the map that you can buy. There's one right there by Hillside, and then the other one is I think it's somewhere up here by like ConAgra and those places or something like that. I can't remember where that one's at. Or no, I think it's right here. That's what this place is. Down here by field 3. Pretty sure that's a grain complex. That's what that is, so. I'm sure someone will complain about me doing that, but oh well. I don't really care. Everything but the tank is fully dirty. Well, both of the tanks, I guess. This tank isn't quite fully dirty. It will be, though, once we move fields, because getting to one of the fields, there's a bunch of mud that we have to go through, so it'll definitely be fully dirty, whichever one we're pulling. I guess, and if the pickup drives through there, too, I guess it will be, but I'd kind of like to redo the BC Buehler pickups in Blender. Separate some pieces and whatnot, and then make it so that it'll work with dirt and that kind of thing. Basically, really all I gotta do is just separate a few pieces and then join a few pieces, and then just making sure that I can have it so that everything only has one material, or even using its existing textures, because then I could only have, you know, then I could apply one material to it and just use, you know, open up the existing textures and whatnot. But I would like to set those up so that they so you can choose what color they are. I think that'd be nice. Okay. Back this rig up. Whoa, wrong direction there. So I am in the tool camera for the applicator. That's why the camera angle is a little odd. So we got a good portion of this field knocked out. Got we're halfway, so definitely after this video I'll make sure that this section is finished and that a good portion of that field or that section is started, and then in the next video we can like finish that section over there or whatever, or get it nearly finished, and then the video and then next week's video on Monday we can knock out that field 13 there, because we'll be able to do that one in a video because it's not very big. So I am contemplating field 17 is in clover. I am contemplating going over to that field and like renting a chopper and a truck and silage trailer and making silage out of that, taking it down to the biogas, and then we can sell that. That would be nice. Make a little extra money doing that. I do believe that we have to sell the grain yet too. No? Did I sell all the corn? I don't remember selling corn. Okay. We need to get out here and we need to go look at this. Why is it not showing corn in there? Maybe it only shows up over here. I don't know. Oh yeah, it only shows up over here. Okay. But the sorghum shows up, so that's kind of weird. Yeah, so we still got to sell the corn too, so that'll make a lot of money. Because there's a lot of corn there. You know, over 500,000 liters, so... So like looking here, let's see, corn 454, 560. Yeah, $560 a ton at county line, so up, oops, wrong button. So up there, bit of a trek, but I think all the sell points are kind of. But yeah, so still gotta sell all that. Maybe we'll wait until the next season, till after this growing season or whatever, and then just sell all the crop at the same time or something, or wait for a great demand or whatever. Whichever happens first, I guess. Even after next season, just waiting to sell each crop until there's a great demand for it or something. Make the most bang for your buck. Or get the most bang for your buck, is what I meant to say. And then be able to upgrade some equipment. Or not really upgrade size-wise, just quantity-wise. Get another combine, get, another planter or something, or get another bigger tractor or, whatever. Whatever it is that we decide to do. The one thing though, if we do chaff field 17, then that means that we gotta go back with... we're gonna hit that, dang it. Is that we do have to go back with this applicator here. And... put down some anhydrous. But if we don't chaff field 17, then we can just plow that stuff directly under with the planter, and then it will then it will just take that crop and turn it into fertilizer, which, you know, would save us money, but at the same time would, I don't know. Let me know what you guys think. Should we chaff field 17 or just plant it all under with whichever planter we use? I guess I'll probably put a card up in the top if I remember. If not, just put it in the comments, but there should be a card there somewhere, maybe. Provided I remember to add it. This dude's elbow's gotta hurt after a while. Jeez. I think the nodes for this, for the character nodes or whatever they are, gotta be moved back a little bit. I don't think he's even quite fully in the seat. I don't know. One thing that would be really, really awesome about this thing is, you see these gauges here? It'd be awesome if those actually, like, read the tank. And, like, you know, when the tank was full, when you put a brand new tank on, it was all the way over there at green, and then just kind of started until you were at 0%. That would be awesome. I don't know if that... Well, it should be able to be done, because, like, there's been feed mixers and stuff that have the digital fill level. So you'd think it would work. But, I don't know, I've never... I mean, I have... Ugh, dang it. I've only used, like, one thing, I think, that has that feature. And that's the, what is it here? Is it in tippers? Oops. Well, it's definitely not in that tippers. Oh, yeah, the Olive trailers. No. Oh, feeding. That's what that should be. Is this Kenworth T800 feed truck? That's the only thing I've ever used in 15, I think. I'm pretty sure. That has, like, the digital numbers on it. So I would assume that that scripting could be incorporated into this to work with that gauge. Because, like, the way that it works, this tank, all it is a fillable trailer. Then the applicator is what actually runs. Because, like, as you can see, turn off blue jet toolbar. So, I mean, that's kind of what, that's what everything runs off of. So, I mean, you'd think that it would work with how this is set up, but I guess, you know, like I said, I don't know. I don't know how that script works, so. Jesus, tractor's hard to drive straight. We're almost done with this little section in the first round, so we got four passes there to do, so probably five, probably I'm gonna guess like 8-9 passes that we'll have to do after these ones. Of course those probably won't be in the video very much, but it does kind of suck. If you see, I've got my map open, but if you look, nothing's the same as it was in the video. Yep, my files got corrupted. I don't know how or why or what, but something messed up in the map 01 folder. So now all of these, I had like six fields done. And one that was like almost done. and actually two that were close to done, because I was doing them like they were side by side fields. And yeah, went on today and my Giants editor wouldn't even open anything at all. Why am I doing this? I can just go like this. And it wouldn't read the editor XML. It said that it couldn't find it or whatever. So then I like uninstalled and reinstalled, and then it wouldn't open my map. And then I was like, well, maybe the files got corrupted, I don't know. So I tried opening one of my backups of my map, and sure enough, the one that I was working on got corrupt. So just had to do about an hour's worth of work all over again, which kind of sucks, but whatever. I guess I should back up like every single time I click save, like every time I finish a field, click save, back it up. That's what I'm gonna do. That way, if I ever get corrupt files again, then I shouldn't be too far behind. Whoops, that was the wrong button. Meant to hit the button to lift it, and instead I hit the button that I used to start and stop the engine. That was nice. Just about done. So you know what? I think we'll actually just make this video a little longer than normal, just to finish off this section here. Then off camera, I can do a bunch more work and get the majority of that other section done. So that way, we can finish it in the next video. You guys might get tired of anhydrous here pretty soon. Might start saying, well, why don't you... Oops, get a little closer. Why don't you just get a sprayer then, or something? But it is definitely nice to be doing something a little different. I don't do anhydrous a whole lot, like I said, so it is nice to be doing it. I'll have to whip around and do that itty bitty spot. Come on, get back over there. It's the only thing about these track tractors that really sucks is they turn so sharp so easily. But it's just what you gotta deal with, I guess, when you use these. Alright, so we got... I can't see because of the dang tree. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we got 7 passes to do. What? Let's go around the pole. How about... Hopefully this tank will finish off this section. Otherwise we'll have to run back and get the truck and bring that other tank back. But this tank has lasted a lot of areas, so if we just make sure that we shut it off and all that good stuff and don't waste anything, we should be all set. I had this thing maxed out at 14. It goes all the way up to 18. Which even 14's 12, it's probably even faster than you actually go in real life. I don't know. Never been around anhydrous. I don't actually know of anybody. Well, maybe. I don't think I know anybody that does anhydrous, but I could be wrong. Yeah, this will definitely last. We only used 3% in these last few passes, so we only got 4 more left, so we should be okay. The faster you drive, the more you can get done, I guess, too, so I guess we'll just go with it. Tractor pull. Oh, I turned way too sharp, way too fast there. I was also trying to look to make sure there's no cars coming down this road. I wasn't just pulling out in front of one that was gonna whack me. I always hate how sometimes they put this grass in the field and you can't get rid of it. It's always annoying. At 17 or so by the end of the pass here. Just about 17%, I'm assuming. Come on. If we make it, it's going to be really close. I also don't want to go too fast because this thing starts wobbling so bad. I don't know why it does that. Probably because of the turning radius it's got or something. I don't know. I've only used 2% so far. Almost to the end. 3. Come on. Fingers crossed, please make it. Fourteen. Yeah, this is going to be really, really close if it makes it. But we can go pretty fast until we go up this hill. That's when we kind of start slowing down. But still, we're doing okay, I guess. Yeah, we should be able to make it. But it will, like I said, it'll be pretty close. We'll probably be at like maybe 10 or 11% by the time we hit the end. So by the time we do that pass, we'll probably have like 3 or 4% left. Maybe more, maybe less. We're at 11. If we don't go below 10, we should be okay. But I have a feeling that we might go below 10. We might hit 10, like right before. Yeah, there we hit 10. Okay, so if we can stay above 9 for now until we hit this end here. Okay. Moment of truth here. See if we can make it to this other end without running out. I'm gonna put the pedal to the floor on this pass here. And you know what? We're just gonna go like this too. I'm gonna try and steer it. No, I'm not. Never mind. That's gonna end horribly. We're at 8. So we should be okay. Yeah, you can see how badly it's wobbling. But just trying to push it to the end. Ah, we'll be okay. We got 7%. We're good. So then we'll hop out on the road, go down to the other end, and end this thing. I'll probably just switch tanks now instead of, or like, you know, we'll go to the, I'll go to the other end, I'll bring the pickup back and just switch tanks right away instead of having to worry about switching like just after I start or something. Okay. So let's get moving here. Go down to this other section. Turn on our flashers here. Take this little cut across shortcut thing. Come on, pick up, go. I thought I had seen a mod a while back that made the traffic go faster. I should go find that. Make that stuff move. It does not go very fast at all. But anyway, guys, so yeah, that's gonna be all for this video. I'm gonna get a bunch of this section done, and then come back on Friday for the rest of it. So thanks for watching, you guys. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to hit that thumbs up button. If you're new to the channel, welcome to the channel. Be sure to subscribe if you like what you see. Be sure to turn on the post notifications to be notified every time I upload a new video. Be sure to check out down below in the description or my PC specs, my upload schedule, as well as links to all of my social medias, my mod site, and some other cool YouTube channels that are worth taking a look at. Thanks for watching, you guys. As always, we'll see you tomorrow.